It's a cold, rainy day today, and I was planning to garden, but I'm not gonna be able to because there's just no way I can be out here right now. So instead, I'm gonna be indoors making ice cream and sourdough bread. And I know that it's January and it's probably not like the ideal time to make ice cream, but it's warm inside. And we've been on an ice cream kick ever since Christmas. I am so deep into this ice cream journey that I picked up, this ice cream container set from Amazon. The package came a little bit beat up, but dun-dun-dun-dun, I need to wash everything. Oh, it even comes with labels. I'm not gonna use these. Hold on. The containers and the lids are dishwasher and microwave safe, but for best results, they recommend only using them in the freezer and hand washing when possible. After use, wash them out immediately to prevent stains and odors. Dry containers and lids thoroughly. Okay, so that's good to know. They're 1.5 quart containers each. And the reason I decided to pick these up is because I've been using all of my Tupperware, and now I have no Tupperware for whenever we need to put food away. So I figured we'd just get some actual ice cream containers, and look how cute these are. So what I think I'm gonna do first is wash them, dry them, and then pop them in the freezer. That way when my ice cream is ready, it can go into a colder container. I was also thinking about purchasing some other ones that were a little bit more pricey and they were insulated, but I was reading reviews of people saying that they crack very easily. So I was like, okay, let me just go with some that are a little bit more basic, but these had really, really good reviews. So first, let me go wash them. We're waiting on the dishwasher to finish them so we can put in another load. Okay, don't judge me. It's a rainy day outside. And it's a weekend, okay? Usually I don't show my sink if there's dishes in here because I want people to think that the dishes are always clean, but they're not. This ice cream was inspired by a Mississippi Mud ice cream sandwich. I don't know if you ever had that as a kid, but my mom used to sell ice cream. In the paleteras or the ice cream truck, she used to carry this one ice cream sandwich called the Mississippi Mud, and it had nuts in it. I don't know if they even make it anymore because I haven't been able to find it in stock anywhere. All of it tasted really good together, but my favorite part was the nuts. So I'm making chocolate ice cream with 3 types of nuts on it. You can just use one or you can use none, but I just think it adds so much and I don't like to skimp out on them. So I'm gonna use some raw walnuts, pecans, and almonds. And I'm just gonna pour a little bit out so that they can start Wait, are these resealable? Oh no. This one is. I'm gonna put some out so they can start defrosting because I keep mine in the freezer. Because one time we bought some large bags like this from Costco too, and I had them in the pantry, but during the summer it gets really, really hot and they went rancid. I usually don't measure, so I'm just gonna show you, okay? 1/4 cup of pecans. Nope, those are almonds. 1/4 cup of pecans, pecans. But like, make sure that it's not, like you're not skimping out, you know? Like actually make sure that it's filled to the top. And then 1/4 cup of walnuts. Oh, fall out. Okay, see? So it's gonna be about this much nuts in 1.5 quarts. You don't get that much in 1.5 quarts usually. You get like a couple little pieces of nuts and the rest of it is just ice cream, and I like it to be super crunchy with every single bite. Okay, so I'm gonna just leave these on the counter so they can start defrosting because they're kind of frozen right now. And I'm gonna start working on the chocolate sauce. First, let me get all the stuff. Cocoa powder. Chocolate chips. I'm gonna try and measure for you because I usually don't do this. So into a little saucepan, I'm gonna add about 1 cup of water. Hold on, let me look. No, maybe like 1.5 cups. No, I'm gonna do 2 cups. I'm gonna do 2 cups of water. Yeah, that looks like it's good enough. So I'm doing 2 cups of water And I'm gonna let that start coming to a simmer. To that, I'm gonna add about 3 tablespoons of cocoa powder. This is the one that I'm using. It's from Costco. The organic fair trade cacao powder, sorry. Cacao powder. And then 3. Let me whisk that up to see if it's dark enough. I might need to add just a little bit more because I like it to be extra dark. Okay, so I'm gonna do 4 tablespoons actually. 4 tablespoons of cocoa powder. See how dark and chocolatey that is? Next, I'm gonna add in some white sugar, some cane sugar. Oh shoot, I didn't measure it, no! Oh, I'm so sorry, I'm just not used to measuring. Let me see. That's not gonna be enough. Let me try it. And it is not sweet enough. Okay, that should be enough. While this is still on the heat, I'm gonna add a little dash of cinnamon. 1, 2, like that. Oh, and then this is the cinnamon. I buy it at Walmart for like $1, ground cinnamon. And then let's whisk that in. And then I'm also gonna add about that much. I also like to add some Mexican vanilla blend. This tastes very different from vanilla extract. I like this way better. It's just what I'm used to, that's what my mom used. And it's a lot cheaper too, because it's not like actual, oh, I forgot to measure it. Damn it. Yeah, maybe like that much. I'm so sorry, I'm telling you, I'm not used to measuring stuff, so I just start tossing stuff in there. I'm also going to add 1/4 cup of chocolate chips in there. I get this big bag from Costco. They're semi-sweet chocolate chips, and that's like the cheapest place I can find them without dairy in them. And I'm gonna keep this on the heat, stirring it until it starts to reduce a little bit because I want it to turn into like a nice thick sauce. I don't want it to be too watery. Chocolate chips. But anyways, okay, let's let that cook down. You can see there's some pieces that are a little bit bigger. I don't want them too big and I don't want them too small. And this is what the chocolate sauce looks like right now. It's nice and silky and beautiful. So every few minutes I'm gonna come over, I'm gonna stir it up just a little bit to get it to cool down. And then once it's cool enough, I'm gonna put it into a Tupperware and pop it in the fridge. And through the magic of television, this is what it'll look like once we're done. Like this, you see? That's the consistency that I want. It's not too thick and it's not too runny. This isn't enough for a batch of ice cream, so I still have to wait for that one to cool down. This one will get to that, but right now it's still just a little too hot. I'm waiting for the steam to stop coming out so that I can put it in the refrigerator. So I've had this in the refrigerator overnight. Okay. There we go. I'm gonna bring my ice cream maker over here just so it's ready. Look how cute it is, and it's pink. This is by the brand Cuisinart. I've had the bowl in the freezer for like 2 days now, but isn't it so cute? We went with the pink version because it was cheaper, and also one of my kids is obsessed with pink, so I figured they'd love it, and they did. They totally did. I'm gonna take my coconut cream. This one has a lot of liquid. I kinda wanna dump out a little bit of the liquid. And I'm gonna scrape out every last bit. No! The dishwasher's on, and all my spatulas are in there. I'm gonna get out every single last little bit. You can of course use like heavy whipping cream, but if you're plant-based or lactose intolerant, this one just works really good because it doesn't upset your stomach. So now that I have all of that in there, I'm gonna whip it up. I bought this little dash thingamabobber. What is this called? Oh, I bought this hand mixer for like under what, 20 bucks, I think. And I got it because it's so freaking cute. I love the color, but also because I have a stand mixer, so I don't really use the hand ones very often. But this one works really well. I bought it at Walmart, and it's by the brand Dash, Rise by Dash. And then on the highest speed, I'm going to beat the coconut cream until it forms soft peaks. I'm gonna add in, let me try and measure it. I'm telling you guys, I don't measure it, but let me try. This is what, half a cup? Definitely gonna use more than this. And then let's beat that in. No, that's definitely not enough. You see the color? It's like a really light chocolate color. Uh-uh. We need like a really dark chocolate color. No, one more. That's looking a lot more like it. Ooh! Why did I do that? Oh, shit. I don't know why I did that. Okay. Since I don't have a spatula, I'm just gonna... I want it to stay nice and airy. It needs at least like one more. Wait, so how much did I do? Yep, there we go. So that's what it looks like so far. Hold on, let me put all this away. Now I'm gonna push this over. Let's bring this baby over here. So I already told you guys, this is from Cuisinart. I bought this one for, how much was this? Like $54, $55. And during Christmas, we played some Christmas games and we won two $20 gift cards. So we use that towards this. So girl math says it's free. No, we made like what, 15 bucks after the gift cards. Here's the bowl. I'm gonna put the inner part in. And then I pour this in here. It's been less than 15 minutes, and look at the ice cream. It's basically ready to go. So at this point, I'm gonna start adding in my nuts. I think it's ready. So we're just gonna take this out, and then look at this. Doesn't that look beautiful? So now I'm gonna start taking all of this ice cream. You can just eat it now if you wanted to. It would be more of a soft serve consistency. I'm gonna put it into the containers. That way it's easier to store and then it stiffens up just a little bit. And then I think it's gonna be like the perfect creamiest ice cream consistency. Oh my God, my mouth is watering. Look, I'm somebody who doesn't like really like sweets. Even ice cream, I don't really usually go for ice cream because me empalago, it's like, oh, I dropped some. It gets to be too sweet for me. This one is not too sweet, but it's just sweet enough. I'm gonna start smoothing it out in here. And then I still have quite a bit in the bowl. We're loving this now when it's winter here in the low desert, but this is gonna be perfect for the summertime because here in Arizona, it gets really, really hot. So we'll be able to have fresh ice cream every week. Let's smooth it out, smooth it out. Next, I'm gonna put a lid on. I'm gonna pop it in the freezer. And there's still a little bit that I couldn't get out of here. So I'll just snack on that. So good. This is so good. Why did I blow on it? Did I tell you how this all began? Like our addiction to making ice cream? Last Christmas, we played White Elephant with my siblings and we bought a little ice cream maker, a little Dash ice cream maker. And we were like, who knows if it works? It was only like 15 bucks and it worked so good, you guys. And so after we tried that one, we were like, wait, we can make our own ice cream? And with that one, the kids loved it, but it was like a little pint. So every single time we would make a batch, it would all be gone within a few seconds. We could only get like a spoonful each. And we wanted to get something bigger that we can actually make cones with, so. And I would 100% recommend this one. I know they have different versions. We just got the pink version and I love it. So now it's just the waiting game. I have two different types of cones here. I have the jumbo ice cream cups and the waffle cones. I get both because my husband likes the waffle cones, but I grew up on these. So for me, I just prefer these. You can use whatever you want. My mouth is watering. And here's our chilled ice cream. I could let this stay in the freezer to get a little bit stiffer, but this one has almonds, pecans, and walnuts. That's bomb too. I think I like these more because they're not as sweet. The waffle cones are really good texture wise, but they're kind of sweet. Don't those nuts make a world of a difference?
Like I can't even see them, but I'm eating them.
Cause I don't have to skimp out on them. I feel like the store-bought ice cream, when they say they have nuts in it, it has like three pieces. Cause each of them has a different like crunchiness. Like the almonds are crunchier than the walnuts and the pecans.
That's true.
That is my favorite type of ice cream. It is probably the one that I'm gonna be making every single week during the summertime. I'll try and experiment with other flavors, but this chocolate with the three varieties of nuts is just amazing. So if you try it out, let me know and I hope you like it.